हेलो एवरीवन, सो लुक एट दिस ब्रांड कंपनीज और इमेज और द लोगोस ऑफ सम कंपनीज, माइक्रोसॉफ्ट, मारुति सुजुकी, नोकिया, टाटा ग्रुप्स, इन्फोसिस, द रिलायंस ग्रुप ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज. Then we are having the Kingfisher and ICICI Bank. So all these are actually multinational companies. So in this video, we will have a discussion on multinational corporation or multinational companies. So these are the very popular brand of MNCs. It may be the Coca-Cola or Microsoft or Hyundai or Nestle. So ultimately, what do you mean by MNC, multinational company? So very simple, MNC is an organization doing business in more than one country. So if you restrict your production and marketing to one country, so that will be called as a domestic company. If you expand your operation to the foreign countries, and if you engage in production and distribution of your goods in foreign countries, so in that case you will be called as multinational companies. So MNCs, they own as well as they control the production of goods and services in one or more countries other than their home countries. So they have a worldwide involvement, and they develop some global perspective with respect to their management as well as all the decisions. Now coming to the definitions given by ILO, the essential nature of multinational enterprise lies in the fact that its managerial headquarters are located in one country, and usually that is known as home country, and while the enterprise carries out operation in number of other countries. Now wherever you will do your operation in other countries, so that will be called as your host country. So let us we will have a clarity on the concept of home country and host country in the coming slide. And as per the Companies Act of 1956, a foreign company in India, actually a foreign company is a company which is incorporated in a country outside India and under the law of that other country and has established a place of business in India. Now let us have a clarity on the concept of home country and host country. Let us take the example of Infosys. Now for Infosys, India will be the home country because the headquarters or the parent country will be India. And Infosys is having their operation worldwide. They are having their subsidiaries in USA, UK, Australia, or Middle East countries. Now all these countries will be considered as host country for Infosys. Means they are having their foreign affiliates through subsidiaries or associates or branches or joint ventures or alliances. Now different terminologies we need to understand here. Transnational corporation, TNC will be called. The term is favored by the United Nations organization. TNC is one which transcends or operates across the national borders, we can say that. And multinational corporation means this term refers to the companies which operate in multiple countries. And this is the most popular term in business as well as in academic circles. And multinational enterprise means actually it refers to again the international giants which are state-owned enterprise rather than corporations. Means there is a slight difference between multinational corporation and enterprise. Both are engaging in more than one country, but with respect to multinational enterprise, that will be owned under the government. And global corporation, this term popular after 1990s, It is often applied to company doing business in several areas of the world. Now, when you talk about history, the concept of the foreign trade or multinational enterprise or corporation to be traced to some civilization period, it may be the Greek or Roman Empire's period, as well as a date back to the Assyria around 2000 BC, and we had Sumerian traders, Italian bankers, and the first foreign company entered India, that may be the Dutch East India Company, and later British East India Company. And after that, the foreign trade concept was again restricted with the tariffs, nationalistic opposition to the foreign trade and investment, and using the competitive advantage and market power. So these corporations originated early in the 20th century and expanded after World War II. A multinational corporation developed new products in its native country and manufactured them abroad. So almost all the earliest and largest multinational firms were either American, Japanese, or West European. Now let us look some facts about MNC. The top 10 ranked MNC in India as per the latest survey, starting from the Vedanta Limited, Maruti Suzuki India Limited, Hindustan Unilever. So like that, the list will be there actually. And the world's 500 largest companies generated nearly $27 trillion in terms of revenues, as well as $1.6 trillion in terms of profit in the previous year, 2020. And as per the Fortune Global 500 companies, they employ nearly 67 million people worldwide and were represented by 33 countries. And as per the Fortune 500 list, the top 10 MNC will be like this according to their revenue in million. So one of the largest retail chain, Walmart, State Grid Corporation, China National Petroleum, Sinopec Group, Royal Dutch, Exxon Mobil, Volkswagen, Toyota, Apple, and British Petroleum. And among the Fortune 500 companies, some of the Indian company, they got their position. So IOCL is there in 161 position, Hindustan Petroleum, Rajesh Exports. And top MNC in Indian, we can see that these are the top Indian MNCs. So all the companies are headquartered in India and they're having their operation in multiple countries. And especially a popular MNC, they're operating in India. So here I made the three bifurcation. So these are the actually the parent companies, but in India they are operating in this particular name and their headquarters means their home country. So Bata Corporation is from Switzerland and they are doing business in India in the name of Bata India. So like that, Cadbury from UK, Coca-Cola from USA, Unilever, they're working like Hindustan Unilever, HUL is from UK, London, and Timex, they are in the field of watches, Colgate-Palmolive, Pepsi Corporation, Philips, one of the largest electrical company, Sony Corporation, Suzuki from Japan, General Electric from USA, and the ABB Corporation, one of the world's largest infrastructure developer from Switzerland. So some statistics about MNC once again. So MNC account for 1/3 of the world trade, and intra-firm trade means the trade between the subsidiaries is nearly accounts for 30 to 40%, and 75% of the MNC's parent corporation means the home countries from advanced industrial countries. And in last 20 years we see an increasing MNC activity in the developing countries. Now let us come to the main concept. the characteristics of MNCs. So first one, MNC, they are having their worldwide operation. So as the term explained, that multinational companies extend their operation to more than two or more countries. Now how they will expand their operation? Now though they establish their parent office in one country and they extend their operation, means they're going global through various modes. It may be having their branches, subsidiaries, as well as their affiliation in other countries in the following modes. That is very important here. So we classified the mode of operation of MNC into three categories. Direct mode. Exporting is one of the very easiest strategy to enter to the foreign market. Raftu maadu antadu. Contractual mode means you are taking the help of the existing company in the foreign country. Maybe licensing, franchising is one of the very popular route here. I think, for example, all the food chains, maybe the KFC or McDonald's. So all these are entering with the franchising mode. Joint ventures are happening, strategic alliance are happening, management contracts are happening, then turnkey contracts or turnkey projects we are saying. The last one, if you are having a long-term interest in the foreign market, then the companies are preferring the foreign direct investment mode. There with the alliance will be happening, that is called as brownfield mode. Mergers and acquisition is happening. And if you have a direct ownership, that will be in the field of fully owned subsidiary, and that is usually called green field mode. And second one, large size. You know that MNCs, they are giant companies, their assets, operations, sales are very large. So we can say that they are the economic powerhouse. Next, huge financial resources. MNCs possess huge financial resources and so have the power to deal with any crisis here, as well as they're having that brand and they're having that credibility, so they can raise fund from any source, as well as very easily they're getting the financial support from the financial institutions. Next, focus on extractive and primary industries. Historically, MNCs actually operating in developing countries have focused on extractive and primary industries. Mainly we can say that petroleum, non-fuel minerals, petroleum, minerals and other plantation activities. But nowadays, the focus is on manufacturing, high technological industries, as well as service industries. Next, the main objective of the MNC is to maximize their profit, increasing the return on their investment. And they're having a huge revenue, we can see here. So the annual revenue of, we observed the top 10 companies listed in Fortune 500 list. So some companies turnover or revenue, we can see that it is equivalent to some country's GDP. So this is very much true that MNC of some countries. So single company's revenue, we can say that it is equivalent to some country's GDP. So they will be considered as the economic powerhouse and preeminent position. So MNC, again, as I mentioned here, incredible position in the world business. So there are about 35,000 MNC around the world today, controlling over 1,70,000 foreign affiliates. And it's estimated that roughly half of the cross-border assets are accounted for just by top 100 MNC in the world. And MNC will use the latest and sophisticated technology here. So when we think about MNC, I think the technology will come to our mind. Because whatever the new products are coming to the market, it is only because of the multinational companies. So as a consumer, they're getting quality products at a very reasonable price. So to meet that international standard, So definitely the company need to make a huge investment in research and development. And MNC also enjoying that professional management. They employ professionally trained managerial personnel to integrate and control their worldwide operation. And finally, there will be a transfer of profit. We are saying that a repatriation of profit. Now, whatever the profit MNC they earned in the host country operation, means in the foreign country operation, usually they will transfer to their home country. But this is subject to the rules and regulation of the government of the host country concerned. Because nowadays some developing country, they made some restriction on the transfer of profit. So MNC made compel to spend their profit earned in the host country itself. So all these are the characteristics of the MNCs. And finally, I think we'll conclude this session by analyzing the reasons for the establishment of MNC. Means why company want to become a global company, or why they want to enter the foreign market. So these are the basic reasons we can find out: to increase their market share, to secure cheaper premises as well as the labor, to avoid or minimize the amount of tax to be paid, or to take advantage of government grants available, to save on cost of transporting the goods to the marketplace, and very important, to develop an international brand. Thank you. Kindly share and comment the video and subscribe my channel.